What's going on, everybody? I'm Andrew Greaves with NAVAC, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about leak detectors. Not just leak detectors, but leak detectors and how they either are or are not impacted by the A2L changes and mandates coming into our industry. I want to cover a little bit of terminology, dispel a few myths, and cut through some of the marketing and sales noise that you've been bombarded by with social media and other mediums that may be pushing you to scrap and replace everything. Let's cut through the confusion. Let's break this down as simply as possible, starting now. So first things first, why is the HVAC industry switching to A2L refrigerants? To understand why HVAC equipment will begin using A2L refrigerants in the coming years, we need to really understand and grasp two main concepts: ozone depletion potential, or ODP, and global warming potential, GWP. The ozone depletion potential measures the impact of a refrigerant on global warming relative to carbon dioxide. Now, historically, the industry has gone through several phases of refrigerant selection focused on reducing both GWP and ODP. Let's take a step back to the 90s and even earlier. The industry ran on CFCs, which are chlorofluorocarbons. Examples of this included R11 and R12. CFCs, while they possessed great thermodynamic properties and did an excellent job cooling, they all possessed very high ODP and GWP properties. Now, with the development of HCFCs, hydrochlorofluorocarbons, which would include refrigerants like R22, R123, we were able to lower ODP, but we still had a very high global warming potential. Now, at the turn of the century, the beginning, the Y2K era, we saw yet again more improvements to HFC refrigerants, hydrofluorocarbons. This changeover was dominated by the emergence of R410A and also refrigerants like 134A. The changeover to HFCs actually brought our ODP to zero, another big improvement. However, GWP still remained high. We saw even more development later on with HFOs, hydrofluoroolefins, HFOs, okay? With these, we got to keep the zero ODP, but now we were finally able to drag down the levels of GWP. Popular examples of HFOs would be R1234YF and 1234ZE. Now, with the EPA's recent HFC Phase Down Act, the industry is now faced with a mandate to again not only have zero ODP, but an extremely low, even lower standard for GWP. And to cut through some of the more unnecessary details in history here, we've emerged with two top players, R32 and R454B. Both of these refrigerants are classified as A refrigerants, or no toxicity. They also fall into an extremely low flammability subcategory, the 2L. These will be the two refrigerants to keep an eye out for that most align with the HVAC requirements moving forward. Now, with that all out of the way, let's cut to the subject matter of the video. Is, and if so, why is NAVAC's HFC leak detector compatible with A2L refrigerants? We begin answering this question with another question. If a leak detector is designed for HFCs, will it be capable of detecting HFOs? And if so, does that make my leak detector A2L compatible? Now again, keep in mind these terms: A2L compatible, A2L compliant, A2L rated. These are all terms that are still up to manufacturers to determine. There is no governing body or agency at this time that has put forth a set of guidelines that officially, legally make something compliant with these terms. So for now, it is up to us to all use our best judgment and hopefully overshoot the safety aspect and the capability aspect of what we imagine these requirements would be. So first, let's look at the main composition of those two rise-to-the-top refrigerants that we see emerging. R32, which is made entirely of difluoromethane, an HFC with zero ODP, and a GWP of 675, which falls below the new 700 GWP threshold. Now, 454B, which is a blended refrigerant, is comprised of roughly 70% R32 and 1234 YF for the remainder, while R1234YF is an HFO. Over two-thirds of the blend is still an HFC. Since NAVAC's leak detector is optimized for HFC detection, it will be fully capable of detecting these two dominant players of 454B and R32, both of which are either completely HFC or dominantly HFC. Now, on the other side of that coin, our leak detector will not detect all possible blends of A2L refrigerants. A2L refrigerants that are either completely HFO in makeup or dominantly HFO in makeup may not be as easily detected as those discussed before. Now, for a more comprehensive understanding of where the NAVAC NML1 leak detector falls with these other refrigerants, refer to the description below this video and we will have an attached document from ASHRAE regarding these A2L refrigerants. If you are a technician that is concerned about your current leak detector's ability to pick up the two dominant A2L refrigerants, take comfort and rest assured your NAVAC NML1 will easily be up to the task. So don't fall into the trap of being told that it's time for your entire van to be gutted and replaced with new tools. Now let's take a minute and talk about sensors. There are two main types of sensors when it comes to refrigerant leak detection: infrared or IR sensors and the heated diode sensor. Now, while infrared sensors have been marketed as more advanced, they are not always superior. Both types of sensors have advantages and disadvantages to discuss. With your IR or infrared sensored leak detectors, they excel in several areas, including very stable readings, as well as a long sensor life. The downside to an IR sensor is that there is a higher initial cost, and as we discussed a minute ago, it may not detect all blends. Again, I'm referencing HFO or HFO dominant refrigerants. With your heated diode sensor, advantages there are very fast responses and high sensitivity. Downside, they have a much shorter sensor life and thus require more maintenance. A common misconception with heated diode sensors is their use of heated elements. They may not be safe with A2L refrigerants due to the flammability. However, this really is a misunderstanding. The operational temperature of heated diodes and these types of sensors is far below the ignition point of any A2L refrigerant. In other words, the NAVAC leak detector is not only compatible with sniffing out and detecting A2L refrigerants, but it also can do so in an extremely safe fashion. I hope this video has been able to clear up some of the misconceptions and confusion surrounding leak detection and tools moving into this new age of A2L requirement. Thank you for letting NAVAC empower you to work smarter.